Hello students, my name is Professor P.M. Sandhya Rani, Chairperson Center for Population Health and Development, School of Development Studies, Tata Institute of Social Sciences, Mumbai. I will be discussing about the module on primary health care from the paper on population and health. Primary health care means that health care is provided in the community for people making an initial approach to a medical practitioner or clinic for advice or treatment. It explains that primary health care, that is PHC, is essential health care made universally accessible to individuals and acceptable to them through full participation and at a cost the community and country can afford. It is an approach to health beyond the traditional healthcare system that focuses on health equity, producing social policy. Primary health care has basic essential elements and objectives that help to attain better health services for all. There are 8 elements of primary health care. Number 1. Education concerning prevailing health problems and the methods of identifying, preventing and controlling them. Number 2. Locally endemic disease prevention and control. Number 3. Expanded program of immunization against major infectious diseases. Number 4. Maternal and child health care including family planning. Number 5, essential drugs arrangement. Number 6, nutritional food supplement and adequate supply of safe and basic nutrition. Number 7, treatment of communicable and non-communicable disease and promotion of mental health. Number 8, safe water and sanitation. Also, there are extended elements in the 21st century. Number 1. Expanded options of immunizations. Number 2. Reproductive health needs. Number 3. Provision of essential technologies for health. Number 4. Health promotion. Number 5. Prevention and control of non-communicable diseases. Number 6. Food safety and provision of selected food supplements. The ultimate goal of primary health care is better health for all. World Health Organization has identified 5 key elements to achieving that goal. Reducing exclusion and social disparities in health, that is universal coverage reforms. Organizing health services around people's needs and expectations, that is service delivery reforms. Integrating health into all sectors, that is public policy reforms. Pursuing collaborative models of policy dialogue, that is leadership reforms. And increasing stakeholder participation. Primary health care is the first point of contact for health care for most people. It is mainly provided by GPS, general practitioners, but community pharmacists, opticians and dentists are also primary health care providers. The aim is to provide an easily accessible route to care whatever the patient's problem. Primary health care is based on caring for people rather than specific diseases. This means that professionals working in primary care are generalists dealing with a broad range of physical, psychological and social problems rather than specialists in any particular disease area. Primary health care approach firstly stresses on a comprehensive approach to health by emphasizing upstream interventions aimed at promoting and protecting health, such as improving household food security, promoting women's literacy and increasing access to clean water. This places a greater emphasis on preventive interventions and counters the biomedical and curative bias of many healthcare systems and promotes a multi-sectoral approach to health. Second, it promotes integration of different clinical services within health facilities, of health programs, and of different levels of the healthcare system. This recommendation was partially in response to the limitation of vertical standalone disease control programs and to the observation that hospitals in many countries were not adequately involved in strengthening primary level health care. Third, it emphasizes equity. This recommendation would, for example, aim to correct the neglect of rural populations as well as socially and economically marginalized groups within many health care systems. Fourth, it advocates the use of appropriate health technology and health care that is socially and culturally acceptable. Fifth, it emphasizes appropriate and effective community involvement within the health care system. And sixth, it adopts a strong human rights perspective on health by affirming the fundamental human right to health and the responsibility of governments to formulate the required policies, strategies, and plans of action. Basic principles of primary health care are: community participation is the hallmark of primary health care, without which it will not succeed. Community participation is a process by which individuals and family assume responsibility for their own health and that of the community and develop the capacity to contribute to their and the community development. Participation can be in the area of identification of needs or during implementation. The community needs to participate at village, ward, district, or local government level. Participation is easier at the ward or village level because the issue of heterogeneity is eliminated. Intersectoral collaboration is the coordination of health activities with other sectors. Such sectors include education, finance, agriculture, information, etc. There should be a working relationship between these bodies and the health ministry. Integration of health services is defined as coordination of various primary health care components into a whole program and made available at all times, including referrals. Equity means that the healthcare resources available in a given community should not be in the handle of a few, and resources should be accessible and affordable to all. Self-reliance involves the use of technological methods and scientifically sound and maintained by the community. It can be in terms of human resources, money, or materials. There are 8 components that is also called elements of primary health care, which are: number 1, immunization; number 2, maternal and child care; number 3, essential drugs; number 4, food and nutrition; number 5, education; number 6, illness and injury; number 7, water and sanitation; number 8, vector and reservoirs. Previous experiences has shifted the focus of the primary health care movement. Early attempts in implementing primary health care were focused on extended access to a basic package of health interventions and essential drugs for the rural poor, concentration on mother and child health, focus on a small number of selected diseases, primarily infectious and acute, improvement of hygiene, water, sanitation, and health education at village level. Simple technology for volunteer, non-professional community health workers, participation as the mobilization of local resources and health center management through local health committees. It was government funded and delivered services with a centralized top-down management. Management of growing scarcity and downsizing, bilateral aid and technical assistance, primary care as the antithesis of the hospital. Primary health care is cheap and requires only a modern investment. Current concerns of primary health care reforms focus on transformation and regulation of existing health systems, aiming for universal access and social health protection, deal with the health of everyone in the community. It is seen as comprehensive response to the people's expectations and needs, spanning the range of risks and illnesses. Promotion of healthier lifestyles and mitigation of the health effects of social and environmental hazards. Teams of health workers facilitating access to and appropriate use of technology and medicines. Institutionalized participation of civil society in policy, dialogue, and accountability mechanisms. Pluralistic health systems operating in a globalized context, guiding the growth of resources for health towards universal coverage. Global solidarity and joint learning. Primary care as coordinator of a comprehensive response at all levels. Primary health care is not cheap. It requires considerable investment, but it provides better value for money than its alternatives. Alma Ata Declaration. The International Conference on Primary Health Care was convened in Alma Ata, Kazakhstan in 1978 and was attended by virtually all the member nations of the World Health Organization and UNICEF. The Alma Ata Declaration of 1978 emerged as a major milestone of the 20th century in the field of public health, and it identified primary health care as the key to the attainment of the goal of health for all. The conference strongly reaffirms that health, which is a state of complete physical, mental, and social well-being, and not merely the absence of disease or infirmity, is a fundamental human right, and that the attainment of the highest possible level of health is a most important worldwide social goal whose realization requires the action of many other social and economic sectors in addition to the health sector. The existing gross inequality in the health status of the people, particularly between developed and developing countries as well as within countries, is politically, socially, and economically unacceptable and is therefore of common concern to all countries. The people have a right and duty to participate individually and collectively in the planning and implementation of their health care. Primary health care is essential health care based on practical, scientifically sound and socially acceptable methods and technology made universally accessible to individuals and families in the community through their full participation and at a cost that the community and country can afford to maintain at every stage of their development in the spirit of self-reliance and self-determination. It forms an integral part of both of the country's health system, of which it is the central function and main focus, and that of the overall social and economic development of the community. It is the first level of contact of individuals, the family and community with the national health system, bringing health care as close as possible to where people live and work, and constitute the first elements of a continuing health care process. In conclusion, we can say that primary health care reflects and evolves from the economic conditions and socio-cultural and political characteristics of the country and its communities, and is based on the application of the relevant results of social, biomedical and health services, research and public health experience. It addresses the main health problems in the community, providing promotive, preventive, curative and rehabilitative services accordingly. Includes at least education concerning prevailing health problems and the methods of preventing and controlling them, promotion of food supply and proper nutrition, an adequate supply of safe water and basic sanitation, maternal and child health care including family planning, immunization against the major infectious diseases, prevention and control of locally endemic diseases, appropriate treatment of common diseases and injuries, and provision of essential drugs. It involves, in addition to the health sector, all related sectors and aspects of national and community development, in particular agriculture, animal husbandry, food, industry, education, housing, public works, communications and other sectors, and demands the coordinated efforts of all those sectors. It requires and promotes maximum community and individual self-reliance and participation in the planning, organization, operation and control of primary health care, making fullest use of local, national and other available resources, and to this end develops through appropriate education the ability of communities to participate. It should be sustained by integrated, functional and mutually supportive referral systems, leading to the progressive improvement of comprehensive health care for all and giving priority to those most in need. It relies at local and referral levels on health workers, including physicians, nurses, midwives, auxiliaries and community workers, as applicable, as well as traditional practitioners as needed, suitably trained socially and technically to work as a health team and to respond to the expressed health needs of the community. Primary health care is recognized as a key component of health systems. Evidence of the impact of primary health care on the health and development of the population supports this assertion. Moreover, the experience acquired in developed and developing countries has demonstrated that primary health care can be adapted to different political, social and cultural contexts. The demographic, social and epidemiological changes that have occurred since the Alma-Ata conference entail the need for an in-depth review of the primary health care strategy so that it can respond to the health and development needs of the world population. Required references are provided here for your sake. Thank you.